Hello, so guys, today I'm going to show you how you can fix your slow downloads on your Xbox One. It also works on the update files, on the DLC packs, or any other game or application. So it works on all of them. It doesn't matter what you download. So the first thing you want to do, actually, guys, is you want to go to the home button. And I just want to say, if you need help during this video, you can just go ahead and join the Airfix club or community and you can ask some questions, or you can just go ahead and comment down below. So the first thing you want to do is we want to close off everything that we are playing right now. So for example, if you are playing Minecraft, for example, or just let's just say Call of Duty, you just want to close that off. It will speed up the application, I mean the download, a little bit faster just by doing that. And as the next step, what you want to do is you want to go to settings. On here, guys, you want to go to general, and on general you want to make sure on network settings, and you want to go to advanced settings. On here, guys, you want to go to alternate MAC address and you want to clear that. And it will ask you to restart your console, actually, but I'm not gonna do it for right now because I'm recording a video right now. So let's go to the next step, what you also can do. So go back to network settings once you restart your console, and don't worry, guys, you won't like lose save data or anything like that. It's safe to do. So what you want to do is you want to test your network speed and statistics. So let's just check it out and what we have. Now, like you see, guys, I just tested my internet connection, and the reason why we want to do this is because we want to know actually the difference it's gonna make. For example, you can actually notice some difference once you try out one of these methods that I'm gonna show you. We got about on download speed 16 Mbps or megabits, upload speed about 3, and our latency is a bit high, but I'm gonna show you how you can fix all of these. And if you have like really slow download speed, it could say on the download speed that it shows you a kbps. So if it starts with a k, it means that your internet connection is really, really bad. I'm gonna show you a fix for that. So let's go back. So the first fix what you can try out is using a Ethernet cable or a LAN cable. So guys, what you want to do is you want to get a Ethernet cable. So if you don't have this, you can just go ahead and check it out in the description down below. So I will leave a link of this in the description down below so you can check it out. And what you do is, like you see on my screen right now, I got connected with Wi-Fi, and we are gonna connect it now with our Ethernet cable. Now what you are gonna see is wired once you connect that. And now let's just go ahead and test our internet connection. And by the way, guys, if you please can like and subscribe though, thank you so much. Now guys, like you see, I just tested my internet connection, and like you see, the download speed increased, the upload speed increased, and the latency got a bit down. So everything is a lot better now, guys. And by getting just a wire connection, you can also fix a lot of errors and things like that. So for example, if you only had about 2 or 4 Mbps on download speed and you get like about 40, it means that your download speed increased by 10 times, guys. Yes, actually by 10 times. And try this out, guys. If you have a router and you can't access it, or if you don't have an Ethernet cable, you can just get one. It's really that simple. It's not like that expensive. So just by getting an Ethernet cable, you can fix it all. So what about the people that don't want to use an Ethernet cable or just want a lot better internet connection than this? So what you can do, and this works also on the people that use Wi-Fi. So this method that I'm going to show you works for the people that use wired and people that use Wi-Fi. Now guys, for the next method, go to advanced settings and now go to DNS settings, and on here click on manual. And now, like you see, I am using a DNS code right now, so you can just go ahead and copy what I just entered right over here. So on my primary DNS, we got 8 dark, 8 dark, 8 dark, 8. And I will just say, guys, the DNS codes don't work for everybody, so it depends on the location where you live on or the country that you live on. And now let's go to the secondary DNS, and here we got 8.8.4.4. So like I said, it all depends on the country that you live on. And I just want to say, guys, once you enter this DNS code in, what you want to do is you want to go back and want to go ahead and try to test your internet connection. So try to test your internet connection if it works better for you or if it gets worse. If it gets worse, guys, you want to go back to advanced settings. But if it gets better, you can just also go ahead and go to advanced settings and try out other DNS codes that I'm going to show you. You can try all of these out and see for yourself which one works the best for you. So for this one, we are doing this. And all of these are free to use, so you don't need to pay. For example, let's just say the 8.8.8. Actually, 8.8.8 comes from Google itself, so it's a Google DNS. And so 1.1.1 is a Cloudflare DNS. So let's go to the secondary, and here we want to enter. You can also just pause the video if you want to. If you want to enter this, just take your time. Now let's go to the next DNS code that we also can use. And like I said, after doing this, go ahead and test your internet connection and see for yourself if it works better or not. On here, guys, now we want to use this. It's a bit longer, actually. And here we have the secondary DNS. Go ahead and test your internet connection. Let's go to the next one. But I will say, guys, a guaranteed fix is just by using an Ethernet cable or a LAN cable. And like I said, you can check that out in the description down below. It will also fix everything. But if these don't work out for you, that will actually fix it. And if that even doesn't fix it, guys, I just want to say it means that your internet service is just too bad. And you can only get better internet service by just calling your provider and ask them to. So like you see the primary DNS, let's go to the secondary. And I just want to say, guys, don't mistake on these primary and secondary DNS codes, because you could get an error code. And also, if none of these DNS codes work out for you, what you want to do is you want to go ahead and change it on automatic. So what you want to do is you want to go to DNS settings and go ahead and use automatic if these DNS codes don't work out for you. But now let's just test out another DNS code. This is the last DNS code that I'm actually going to show you guys. So I did something wrong. It was okay, I remember. And here we have the primary. Let's go to the secondary one. Don't forget to pause the video if you want to. And here you have the last one, and that's the secondary DNS. So now let's just click on start. and go back, and like you see, our internet connection is all good. You can just go ahead and try to test your internet connection. For me, just for me personally, 8.8.8 works the best for me. Also, the 1.1.1 works also good for me. The 7.7 also works a bit good, but the best ones are the 8.8.8 for me. And that's just it, guys. So I just want to say, once you tested all of your internet connection, and you just go ahead, let's just sign in really quick. Now we are signed in. So you can just go ahead and test your download speed and see for yourself if it gets better or not. So this is actually how you fix your low download speed. And I just want to say, if you need more help or if you have questions, you can just go ahead and join the Airfix community and we'll help you out. So thanks for watching, guys. Please like, subscribe and comment down below, and take care of yourself, guys. I hope you fix this slow download speed problem.